These are the Suvorovtsy, boys studying at the Soviet military schools named after Field Marshal Alexander Suvorov. Major General Koklov in charge of the Suvorov School in the city of Tula. The boys enroll at the age of 8 and graduate at 17. Most of them are often sons of Red Army officers and soldiers killed in action, or sons of guerrillas who fought behind enemy lines. Some of these boys took active part in the fighting against the Germans, mainly as scouts. Sergei Alyoshkin is one of these guerrilla boys. The Nazis killed both his father and mother, and the boy was finally adopted by a guards regiment. He was awarded a medal for saving the life of his commanding officer, who was wounded in battle. The 9-year-old hero Sergei is writing, "I live in Tula." The study of foreign languages, particularly English, is an important part of a Suvorov school curriculum. This classroom is especially popular with the future generals and officers of the Soviet armies, for it contains all types of arms. Although the Suvorov schools are military institutions, the basic curriculum is that of the state schools, and includes classes in grammar, geography, history, and arithmetic. The boys are also taught drawing, music, and dancing. This is a copy of a famous Russian painting, "The Morning Comes to the Woods" by Shishkin. Our old friend, the hero Sergei Alyoshkin, is a bit nervous at the piano. This is his third music lesson only. Suvorovtsy drill every day, summer or winter. They are taken care of exceptionally well. They have good quarters, fine uniforms, 4 square meals a day, and excellent medical care. The city of Leningrad. Leningrad is proud of its Nakhimov School, a naval academy for boys named after the hero of the Crimean War, Admiral Nakhimov. A dance for the future admirals and captains of the Soviet Navy. There will be more dancing soon, but in the meantime, the guest of honor, Captain Morosov, tells the children stories of the recent past. As they gather around him, the captain recalls the faraway shores of the Barents Sea in the north. The sea was angry and dangerous in those days of fighting against the Germans, and it took men of strong will, great stamina and courage to challenge the sea and the invader. The Germans had fortified themselves on Cape Bezimyanaya, and they had a powerful gun battery. Russian sailors were ordered to capture the Cape and destroy the enemy to a man. It was a tough and dangerous undertaking, but the Russians braved the sea, and they braved enemy fire, stormed the Cape and captured it after a long struggle. Yes, those were days of danger and glory, and there is no end to the stories one could tell. It's getting late, and there is that last waltz. Mm-hmm. suppose we are somewhat clumsy and a bit too solemn. Nietzsche Ball, there are still years and years of practice ahead of us.